afternoon, everyone. Happy Freethought Day. And happy Atheist Day. I'm so happy to be here. This is my second Freethought Day. I was here 3 years ago now. And I'm very, very happy to be back in Sacramento. And just a big round of applause to all of the organizers and, of course, David Diskin for putting together today, and all the volunteers who have been taking such good care of us. And the first song I'd like to share with you today is a response to a question that comes up, or a discussion that comes up, when people find out that I'm an atheist. Sometimes people will ask, well, how do you know how to be a good person without God? Or how do you know the difference between what's right and what's wrong without a book to tell you? And I don't necessarily, it doesn't come up too often, but sometimes it goes as far as to ask, what's stopping you from killing and stealing from everybody? So I don't want to argue those people out of their beliefs too quickly. But my answer to that question, I put into a song. Because the great thing about a song is that it's really an uninterrupted 4-minute opinion. And goodness knows we don't get too many of those these days. So this is my 4-minute uninterrupted opinion of how I know how to be a good person without a God, and how I know the difference between what's right and what's wrong, how I make those decisions inside myself. And this song is called My Morality. Has nothing to do with the Bible or the verses of the Quran. My morality won't judge you by your spirituality, but by the things that you have done. My morality is not set into stone tablets. Don't even tell you not to hurt children. My morality is not dictated by a deity. It's developed from empathy, dependence, and love. My morality accepts everybody's sexuality, is more concerned with inequality than validations from above. My morality is not set into stone tablets. Who don't even tell you that it's worthwhile to be good for being good's own sake. That not to think for yourself can be a deadly mistake. My morality is not recitable from memory. It's something inside of me, how I wanna be. Treat others how I want them to treat me. Basically, not to hurt anybody.
wars. Any brutality, it stems from our common humanity. And it's what my grandmother taught to me. And it's mine because I'm free.
Thank you. I'd like to introduce Rob, Andrew Robertson. This song I wrote for a friend I was arguing with about evolution, and he didn't believe in evolution, even though he won an essay writing competition about evolution and was invited to the most prestigious university in our state to talk about evolution, which he didn't believe in. And so I was arguing with him about this, and I said, you know, you understand the mechanism, obviously, so you can just look at the evidence and see that it's there and it backs up the theory. And he said, I don't want to look at the evidence. He said, I already suspect my life is meaningless, and I don't want that to be confirmed. And I wrote this song for my friend and also for my parents a little at the time. And it's for somebody who's holding on to a belief, not for its truth value, but for the way that it makes them feel and the comfort that it brings. I think maybe we're all guilty of this sometimes. The song is called House with No Walls.
That's why you choose to live. that's why you choose to live in a house with no walls.
Thank you. Got some exciting noises coming up. This next song is about somebody trying to interfere in a relationship. When I was 18 years old, my father told me that I needed to break up with my partner because he wasn't Jewish. Fat chance of that. But I think there's so many reasons why people try and interfere in a relationship. Religion is something that comes up very often. Race, gender, orientation, all these kinds of things, but really, you can't help who you love, you can't change who you love, and people will try and stop love, but they can't get in the way. And this song is called Somebody Like You. Thank you. I've got some hecklers in the front. this song is a flash, a little flash of what it was like to be a young woman growing up in Judaism. And I am part of a Jewish family in a Jewish community, which I would describe as medium Jew. So that means, you know, moderate level of observance and keeping the dietary laws and keeping the festivals and going to synagogue every week. But the synagogue that we went to was an Orthodox synagogue, so that's well done, Jew. And at the synagogue we had gender segregation. So the women will sit upstairs and the women aren't allowed to participate in leading the service. As a woman, I'm not allowed to sing unaccompanied in the synagogue. I'm not allowed to get up like my father and my brother and sing and lead the congregation, even if I have the best voice in the room. Somebody's lost. But in Orthodox Judaism, men and women aren't allowed to touch. So the rabbi would come to visit my family and shake my brother's hand and shake my father's hand. And hi, Shelley. Hi, Jenny, Shelley's mum. And every once in a while, you'd get a cool rabbi that you could get an air high five going with. But you're not allowed to touch. You're not allowed that same level of closeness and friendship. I went to a Jewish school, which was more in line with my home life in terms of being a moderate level of observance. But even there, we got a very clear message about what it meant to be a woman in Judaism. Every morning during prayers, we would recite a call and response between the boys and the girls. And the boys would say in Hebrew, this is from age 10, by the way, the boys would say, "Dear God, thank you for not making me a woman." And we would answer back, "Dear God, thank you for making me what I am." And so this song captures little flashes of these moments, but it also talks about the way that all of the Abrahamic traditions talk about women and women's roles, and their liturgy talk about women and women's roles. And often this is explained away to me by people, women within my community, who say, "This doesn't mean that you're lesser. This doesn't mean that you're not as good. It just means that you're different." But different is still defined, and I refuse to be defined by my gender. This song is called Eve. Yeah.
has nothing to do with where I've been. It is part of who I am. It is because I corrupt man. I was asking for it just by being a woman.
This is a new song. I played this at a Reason rally, and very, very excited to be at the Reason rally. Now this song, it's got a sing-along part in it, and normally I don't like sing-alongs very much, but I thought, you know what, it's the Reason rally, I'm going to do it, I'm going to get everyone to sing along with me, and I did, and then Thunderfoot made a video of the Reason rally and was making fun of my sing-along. So, I'm going to do it again. And hopefully you're all going to join in and help me and make it an awesome sing-along. So I'm going to teach you the part and you'll hear it come in. It's like an ooh, ooh, ooh kind of thing. So I'll teach it to you now, and then when we come into the chorus, you guys can help me out with it. So, I'll sing it to you once. It goes like this. Oh, give it a try? All right, 1, 2, 3. Oh, 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 oh. That's beautiful. Why wouldn't anyone like sing-alongs? It reminds me a little bit of church. Well, not for me, I didn't get to sing along, but no. So this song is about seeing the beautiful side of things, not in an ignorant way, but just, not in a way of denying the reality that's there, but choosing to focus on what's good and what's beautiful and being inspired by that. And this song is called Pretty Side.
See your pretty side, I see it all so bright. I run up and down on the street till I light the night. But what if you're not who you say you were? I see your pretty side, sign of sure in my eye. I display it up and down the street till they all take flight. But what if you're not who you said you were? And it's not perfect, I know everything's not perfect, but I see the pretty side of everything, and sides, Caucasook and I decide. On the backs of all these inaccurate daydreams I ride, till I'm not sure who you said you were. Is this my pretty side? To see old pretty sides, I run up and down the street till I light the night. But what if you're not who you said you were? And it's not perfect, I know everyone's not perfect, but I see the pretty side of everything. Push the darkness to the side. If we don't choose to close our eyes, when we let the light break through, the pretty side comes into view. Oh, I hope you see it too. Oh, I hope you see what I see, the pretty side of everything. And in your eyes is lightning, I just see the pretty side of you. Oh, 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 oh. Last time, oh, oh, oh.
Thank you so much. Did you sing along, Rob? No. I didn't hear you. Thank you, everyone, for joining in. Appreciate it. Now, this song I wrote for a very special young lady who was part of our community. If anyone's familiar with Teen Tiny Dancer, there was a young girl, 11 years old, who was battling cancer, and she lost her battle very recently, but through the whole process, her and her family shared their experiences online, and I know that they inspired hundreds and hundreds of people around the world with the strength, with an incredible strength. Her name was Samantha, and she had two hashtags that she used to keep her going, and one was never give up, and the other one was keep on smiling. And this family have changed the way that I will approach grief and tragedy in my life, 100%, because it was just unrelenting, and it was so beautiful. And so I wrote this song for them, and I tried to capture that idea of just never giving up. So I'd like to dedicate this to Sammy, and this song is called The Fighting Song.
We got a fighting precious and sweet. You are not alone, so don't ever give up. We are in this together, and enough will never be enough.
Thank you so much for being so encouraging. Thank you to Rob. I wrote this song after a preacher in the street told me that I was going to hell. Told me very nicely, very politely, that I was going to burn forever. And I felt angry, because who is this person to come into my world and my life and tell me how I should live my life? And this song says, I will not be told how to live my life. And this song is called Saved. Thank you very much for having me.
think suffering is part of some great plan that's been devised. I wonder what will it take for you to start opening your eyes, to start questioning the bullshit everyone around you buys. You think it's any of your business what goes on between my thighs. I wonder when they'll be rid of your lies, of your lies.
Thank you so much. My name is Shelley Segal. Come say hi, and if you like hugs, I like hugs too.